Group one will be starting. The first one, is it already? If we move on to the document,
just second, Abhijit. Once,
yeah. Yeah, this is the first topic and will be presented by Shivam. Shivam, you have.
Thank you, Abhijit. Good morning, everyone. I'm here to talk about the graduation ceremony of Japanese students known as Sotsugyo Shiki. They are normally weekday ceremony, normally after the last day of exams. Ceremony with batch-to-batch speeches starting with the principal, that is Gocho, followed by Parent Teachers Association representative and a student representative as well. Attending dignitaries are then introduced by the principal. After this, all students are called one by one and receive certificates. The dress code is normally their uniform, seifuku. Although trends are changing and it is common to see boys wear suits and girls using kimono. To sum this all up, Sotsugyo Shiki is an important event in a normal school student in Japan, and the transition is from school to university. Now the keywords: Sotsugyo Shiki, Japanese graduation ceremony, seifuku, uniform. Thank you.
Thank you, Shivam. Next, the next topic will be presented by Akshita. Akshita, you have the stage.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. I'll be introducing you all to Shime Kazari. So as you can see in this picture, the small ornament that has been hung at the entrance gate is called a Shime Kazari. It is a New Year decoration that is hung at the entrances of houses as soon as Christmas is over, and it stays put till the first week of January. It is made up of various decorative elements which have their own traditional beliefs. It consists of Shime Nawa, which is a sacred rice straw rope found at the Shinto shrines with zigzag paper strips called Shidin. They are believed to keep a place sacred and ward off evil spirits. And this is the reason why they are commonly found at Tori gates of shrines, since it marks the border to pure space where only gods can descend. Generally, a Shime Kazari also consists of fern leaves and pine twigs depicting hope, prosperity and eternity, since pine twigs stay green for a long period of time. It also has a bitter Japanese orange which is called Dai Dai, and it is considered as a good omen among Japanese people, because if Dai Dai is written with a different kanji, it means from generation to generation. To sum everything up, Shime Kazari is a New Year decoration which is believed to bring good luck to a family and to protect the house from evil spirits. Now on to the keywords. The first one is Shime Kazari, which means the New Year decoration. And the second one is Shime Nawa, which is the rice straw rope found at the Shinto shrines. Thank you.
Thank you, Akshita. The third and next topic will be presented by me. I'm here to talk about Obon. Obon, or simply known as Bon, is a Buddhist custom that is used to honor one's ancestors. Common customs include visiting one's ancestral properties and also cleaning up the graves of their ancestors. It is normally held for 3 days, although the starting date changes from region to region. This is because of the shift from the lunar calendar to the Gregorian calendar in the Meiji era. The first kind of bon is Shichigatsu bon, also known as July bon. This is based on the solar calendar, and the starting date is from the 15th of July. Eastern regions, such as Kanto and Tohoku regions, follow this. The next is Hachigatsu bon, also known as August bon. This is based on the lunar calendar, and the starting date is the 15th of August. This is the most celebrated obon. The last one is Kyu bon, also known as old bon. This follows the old lunar calendar and is celebrated on the 7th month of the lunar calendar. Since the date changes from year to year, it's normally held between 8th August and 7th September. The Shihoku and Chugoku regions and also the Okinawa prefecture follow this. Obon is thought to originate from the ghost festival of China. An important aspect of Obon is the Bon Odori. It is a dance style and is thought to be a form of folk entertainment. To sum it all up, Obon is a festival that is used to honor one's ancestors in various styles, and the most common feature of this is the Bon Odori. Bon Odori is a style of dance that is usually accompanied by the local music. Region to region, the dance style and the music changes. And now the keywords are Obon, or simply Bon. It literally refers to the festival of Obon. The second one is Bon Odori. Odori refers to the movement and dance that is accompanied with the festival. So Bon Odori is the style of dancing that is associated with the Bon festival. Thank you. Now we will move on to the next topic. This will be presented by Karthik. Karthik, you have the stage.
Thank you, Abhijit. Good morning, everyone. I will be talking about higher Japanese college graduation. Here we have two university students at their graduation ceremony. Though it's not typical for this occasion, we see that they are wearing kimono and hakama. In the Japanese context, graduation from college is considered to be a rite of passage to becoming a psychiatrist or a contributing member of society. Japanese university students usually start looking for work at the beginning of their final year, so it's not uncommon for some to move from college to the workforce directly. In that sense, for many Japanese people, the graduation ceremony marks the transition from the academic hierarchy to the corporate hierarchy. Now on to the keywords. We have daigaku tsutsuke shiki, which means college graduation ceremony, and hakama, which is a type of traditional Japanese clothing I adopted from the Chinese in the 6th century. It is normally worn over a kimono. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Karthik. Next, we will move on to Utkarsh.
Thank you, Abhijit. Yeah. Good afternoon, everyone. Here I'm going to talk about Hina Matsuri. Hina Matsuri, also called Girls' Day or Girls' Day. It is a special day in Japan. It is celebrated each year on March 3rd. This is a day for thinking about the happiness and health of young girls in Japanese families. The prototype for the doll festival dates back to the Heian period, which is over 800 years ago. It is a traditional custom to display ceremonial dolls on tiers of slips covered with a scarlet carpet. These dolls are dressed in the fashion of the people of the ancient court. The emperor and empress are placed on the uppermost tier, followed by the ladies in waiting and ministers. This festival was traditionally known as the Momo no Seiku, which means seasonal festival of peach blossom flower. As peach tree typically began to flower around this time, or in the past, peaches were believed to have the power to destroy evil spirit. Therefore, peach flowers are used for decoration at the doll festival. To sum it all up, Hina Matsuri is a festival of dolls that is celebrated on March 3rd. It is used to pray to prosperity on young girl. Now I am coming to the keyword. The first is Hina Matsuri, in English, Dolls Day, also Girls Day, in which it is an annual event to pray for the healthy growth of girls. And the last one, that is Momona Seku in English, seasonal festival of peach blossom, in which a pastry typically begin to flower during this time. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Utkarsh. Now we have the final presentation from our group. Ardra, you have the stage.
Thank you, Abhijit. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm here to talk about Kado Matsu. Just like Shime Kasari, Kado Matsu are Japanese traditional New Year decorations. It's made up of bamboo and pine. After Christmas, from December 26, Kado Matsu are placed in the entrances of houses and buildings in Japan to invite the Shinto god Toshigami-sama to bless the location for the coming year. This is derived from the belief that divine spirits reside in trees. They are placed in pairs representing male and female. And after mid-January, Kado Matsu are ritualistically burned to appease and release gods. So to sum it all up, Kado Matsu are traditional Japanese decorations on New Year that are believed to bring blessings for the coming year. So I'm coming to keywords. First one, Kado Matsu. That means New Year pine decoration. The word Kado means gate and Matsu means pine. The second one is Yorishiro. It means object representative of divine spirit. So here, Kado Matsu is the object that represents the divine spirit, Toshigami-sama. Thank you.
Thank you, Ardra. Now I will be handing it over to the second group's leader, Arpit. You can take over.
Thank you, Abhijit. Now here on, we'll be starting with the group two presentations. And to start with, Vamshita-san, can you please brief us about the first slide? Hi, Vamshita-san.
Hi. Good afternoon, everyone. So I'm going to present this one. And this picture shown here, it is Koinobori, which is called carp streamer. And Koinobori represents Children's Day, that is on May 5th, which was traditionally known as Tanguno Seku, which is Boys' Day, where even now it's majorly known for boys, but then both boys and girls celebrate it together. And it is a national holiday. It takes place on the last day of Golden Week, where there's a large break for workers and also a week in which businesses are usually closed. The carp-shaped flags are flown against the wind to represent the well-being of children, as koi fish symbolizes good luck, abundance, and perseverance by going against the stream and reaching their destination upstream, which means children will have to face various problems and they should overcome the obstacles to reach their goal. The wind socks are made of paper, cloth, and other non-woven fabric, which are drawn on which carp patterns are drawn. So the keywords in this is Koinobori, which is carp streamer, which means it's actually kind of like a role model for children to have courage and the ability to read, to attain their goals. Thank you.
Thank you, Amshita-san, for the beautiful presentation. Next, Srimul-san, can you please take us through the 8th one? Hi, Srimul-san.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. I'm here to introduce you to Kagami Mochi. Kagami Mochi is used as a New Year decoration as well as an offering to the god. Kagami Mochi literally translates to mirror rice cake. The arrangement consists of rice cakes, one larger and one smaller, which is topped by a bitter orange called dai dai. And often fern leaves and seaweeds are used to decorate it. The kagami mochis are kept on a sheet called shihobeni, and the whole arrangement is kept on an offering table called sampo. The kagami mochis represents the year that just passed and the year that yet to come. And the dai dai literally translates to generations to generations, which symbolizes the continuity and bonding of generations. The kagami mochi are kept till January 11th, On that day, the mochis are broken by a wooden hammer during a ritual called Kagami Biraki or opening of Kagami. They never broken using a knife because it symbolizes that you are cutting down your family ties. So the broken mochis are used to make ozoni, and this is considered as the first important ritual of the year. And the keywords related to this picture are Kagami Mochi, which is mirror rice cakes, and Oshogatsu, which is the Japanese New Year. That's all for today. Thank you.
Thank you, Shimon-san. Moving ahead, Quinton will be relying on you for this one. Hi, Quinton-san.
Thank you, Arpit. Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm going to explain you about the weaning ceremony of a Japanese baby. Okay, so this one goes by the name Okui Zome or Hyakunichi no Oiwai, the first eating ceremony for the baby after 100 to 120 days of his birth. It's the wish for the baby not to miss the meal forever or to never face any kind of shortage of food. Since he or she can't eat in reality in just 100 days, so it's just a ceremony to feed the baby. The order is to decided like this. The rice with soup, rice with fish, or boiled vegetables with rice soup. The rice is thought to be very important for the Japanese meal, so people feed the baby fish, boiled food, vinegar inside, in between rice. Since this photo is for a girl, outside of the bowels we can see it's totally black, while inside is red. If it's for a boy, the ball is all red. It's the tradition to feed a baby by the oldest person in the family who joined the Okui Zome ceremony. And this meal is basically prepared by the grandmother. But these days, since the trend is changing, people often go to celebrate this event in a pre-booked place where they invite all the family members. Sometimes this is also called as Hashi Zoroe, that is chopsticks preparation, or Hashi Hajime, the first chopsticks, as it's the first use of the chopsticks. So Okui Zome is celebrated in order to pray for the well-being of the baby. Now, over to keywords. Hyakunichi no Oiwai, that is 100th day celebration, and Okui Zome, that is weaning ceremony, the first food which is fed to the baby by the elder. Thank you.
Thank you, Quinton-san. Next, Bhavani-san, can you please lead us through the next slide? Thank you. Bhavani-san.
Hi. Good afternoon. Here we have, in the picture, as you can see, is a little boy dressed in his best formals, all ready for the Chittigosan festival. Chittigosan, or the 753 festival, is an annual event held on the 15th of November to celebrate the growth of young children. Usually, boys of ages 3 and 5 and girls of ages 3 and 7 are celebrated. In the past, say around the 1400s, give or take a few, due to poverty and poor health conditions, many have lost their children. Chittigosan is thought to have emerged as a way of thought to mark important milestones in a child's development. On a less somber, more sweet note, the children get to have Chitose Ame. Chitose Ame, or the thousand-year candy, are long, thin, red and white candy sticks that symbolize healthy growth and longevity. So to sum it up, on the 15th of November, parents dress their kids in their best clothes and visit local shrines to pray for the child's health and good fortune. The key terms are Chichi, Go, and San, which translates to 7, 5, and 3, as these are the three ages that are celebrated. Thank you.
Thank you, Bhavani-san. Next, I request Abhirami-san to help us with the 11th slide. Hi, Abhirami-san.
Thank you, Arpit. Good afternoon to all. Now, I'll be introducing you to Kakisome. Kakisome is a Japanese term for first calligraphy written at the beginning of the year, traditionally on January 2nd. The word Kakisome is written with the characters for right and first. This tradition goes back to the Kiso Hajime, the first official events in Imperial Court performed on January 2nd. Traditionally, Kakisome was performed using ink rubbed with Wakamitsu, the first water drawn from the well on New Year's Day. Kakisome is an important New Year's event for Japanese to wish a year filled with happiness. Recently, many Japanese high school students are assigned Kakisome as their winter break homework. there is a famous phrase, Shoho Hito Nari, which means calligraphy reveals character. This notion is quite common among Japanese people and contributes a strong emphasis on having a beautiful handwriting. So on to the keywords, they are kakisome, which means first writing, and oshokatsu means new year. So basically, kakisome is a festival celebrated on new year for the prosperity of everyone. Thank you.
Thank you, Virami. Yeah, saigo, Vijay-san, onegai shimasu. Hi, Vijay-san.
Hi, thank you, Arpit. Good afternoon, everyone. Today, I'll be talking about ozone. Ozone is, the word itself means miscellaneous stuffs, vegetables, etc. that are boiled. And it's a New Year's soup that is eaten by Japanese people on January 1st, 2nd, and 3rd as a breakfast. The soup is made of either soya sauce and dashi and salt, or miso soup. The different regions have different ways of preparing, but the main ingredient there is the rice cake, that is mochi. In the Kanto region, they prefer square or rectangular shaped mochi rice cake with a clear soup of made of soy sauce, dashi and salt. But in the Kansai region, it is preferred to be round with white miso soup. The other ingredients can be vegetables like carrots, radish, and local vegetables that are present, and mitsuba. It's a parsley-like herb that is found in Japan. Or in places where there are seafoods available in abundance, they also use seafoods. But in places where you can't find these, like the hilly areas, they use mushrooms in the soup. The Kanto region here is the areas that are the Tokyo, Chiba, and other neighboring prefectures. Kansai area are Kyoto, Osaka, and other neighboring Nara and other prefectures. The keywords here are ozoni and oshogatsu. Ozoni is the soup and the oshogatsu is the new year. Basically, to sum it all up, it is the soup that represents coming of the new year. Thank you.
Thank you, Vijay-san. With this, we have come to the end of the group 2 presentation. I would like Abhijit-san to take on from here.
Yeah, thank you, Arpit. To all the people who have come out of the way to take part and look at our presentations, we would like you to note that there's a feedback poll on Zoom. And after the polling, the documents which you have seen on the screen will be sent to your respective email addresses. I would also like to explain
just a second. Sorry for interrupting. Let me do the polling first. Okay. Just a second.
Okay.
Yeah. The team presenters will also get the poll. You need not click on it. Abhijit, go ahead. The polling is over. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Sensei. So, after the polling, please note that the documents which you have just seen on the screen will be sent to your respective email addresses. And also, I would like to say a few words on what Get to Know Japan or GTKJ actually is. GTKJ was started by EFLU's 2019 batch as a fun way to introduce to the layman in a fun way the various aspects of contemporary Japan. With this, I would like to say thank you to all the attendees, and we hope that you'll support us in our future endeavors, and hope that more and more people will be excited about learning various aspects of Japan, and we also get various opportunities to explain to the normal people why we are doing what we are doing, and hope that we can spread the word in a better and more fun way. And with that, I would like to thank everyone again, reiterating from coming out of your way to wasa wasa kite kurete hontoni arigato gozaimasu.
Okay, so first year students, please stay back. The rest of the audience, thank you for participating today.